With betrayal, really, the secret of the book is in the title, because it is about a terrible, terrible betrayal. Not only a husband and a wife, but a father and a son, and the brothers. It's a huge, big family saga, really, I suppose, an epic, you know. And the main character, he will betray anybody, and he betrays everybody around him. I think, like most of my storylines, I think I got Aidan and Jade from, you know, I wanted an older woman this time. I really did want an older woman, you know, and I wanted it to be someone who was very sexy and voluptuous and with a younger man, which I think all women should do at some point in their life. No, I'm joking, but I just thought she was a really powerful character. She'd been in the business that she was in for so long, you know, the sex industry. He was just being introduced into the world of criminality, and I thought that they made a really good team, because he learnt so much from her, but he didn't learn quite enough. Well, not enough to keep him safe, anyway. Oftentimes, when I'm thinking late at night in bed, I sort of come up with a character, I'll come up with a storyline. Sometimes I get the character first and I build a storyline around the character, such as Jade and then, you know, Aidan. Other times, like with the take, I'll get a character like Freddie Jackson and then I'll build the story around him, you know, obviously. And you think, what would this person do? What kind of love would they be in? And that was pretty much what happened with Aidan and Jade. I thought of those as a relationship. And, you know, what kind of world could I put them in that, you know, that would really test the boundaries of, you know, anything about them? Well, I don't know. I think I'm quite a strong woman, so I think that might have, you know, me being as strong as I am might sort of be why I write so many strong women. I am really attracted to strong women. I think we give birth with, you know, the fact that we give birth, I think, makes us stronger anyway. And also, I think women can be much more violent and much more aggressive than men, but you have to push us that bit further. When I'm researching a book, my research sort of takes in so many different people and locations and places. And I mean, I didn't have to do that much actual research for this book as opposed to where they live, because it's where I've been my stomping ground all my life. I think the main research that I did for this was talking to women who'd been in the sex industry, you know, and who had actually worked as maids and things like that, as opposed to women who'd been prostitutes or whatever, you know. And it was very interesting. I had some very, very funny stories. Very, very tragic stories. And also, I think my books all have this element of truth running through them, you know, about where the houses are. You know, maybe these houses that I write about now aren't there anymore, but they certainly was at one point. There would have been a house of ill repute, where I say. and it was just really interesting. It's great. I like to walk the streets as well, you know, and get a feel for the area where I am, whether it's King's Cross or wherever you are. And I think that comes across my readers because, you know, there's an element of realism in it, and people assume the stories are real as well. I really, really like the past, and I'm a 70s girl, you know, so a lot of my books are set in the 70s. I was just a child in the 60s, but I still remember it very well because it was my, you know, my infants and junior years. I really like to delve into the 60s and 70s for the simple reason that was when real, you know, sort of, it was the old style criminality. So it's much more interesting than, say, the 80s, you know, with the drugs wars and the Yardies and the Russians and everybody else turned up. So the 50s, 60s and 70s, are, you know, for me, they're my favourite eras to write about. And also, I think you've got the clothes, you've got the cars, you haven't got the internet, which for me is fantastic. You know, because you couldn't get someone in 10 seconds if you wanted them, you had to look for them. And I often think with my kind of book, that adds a lot of the, you know, it sustains, you know, sort of all the, will they, won't they, will they find them? So yeah, I enjoy the past. I don't have to do much research because I sort of, it was my era, but also I can't go past a second-hand shop without buying an A to Z. You know, if I find a 1950s A to Z, I buy it. Because so many places have changed, you know, one-way systems, you know, and different things. And I like my books to be factually accurate if I can. So, yeah, I do tend to buy a lot of stuff from the past, you know. When I'm writing, I feel it's time for a character to go. I pretty much go with my flow as how I feel at the time. Sometimes I was reading Lady Killer back years ago and I was really, really shocked that George killed the child. I couldn't believe it because I really didn't expect to do that when I was writing the book. And I think it was the same with the ending of Get Even, because it is quite a, it's a very ruthless ending, and it's and there's no pity. There's no real pity, although, you know, he's sorry for what he's done. You know, he doesn't really feel any pity at all. And I think when you're actually writing the book, I think as the author, you know, and you're living all these different lives, you know, you have to make sure that you finish a character, you know, with as much energy as you began them, you know. I think people say that I've got a unique genre, although obviously there's lots of people writing in Martina Coldstone now. I always wrote for me, and I still write for me. If I do a writer's conference, or if I'm in the prisons doing writing workshops, I always say the same thing. Write something you want to read. Don't think, oh, this is selling, or that's selling, so I'm going to write like that. I always say, write what you want to read, and that's what I did when I wrote Dangerous Lady in 1981, all those years ago. You know, I just wanted to put a woman in a different world, you know, than you know, sort of a housewife and a mother and or the fashion industry or, you know, modelling or acting. And so I, you know, I mean, it's 25 years next year for Dangerous Lady. I mean, I can't believe that. It's been 25 years. And I was only 12 when I wrote it, if anyone else. But it's sort of, I just wanted to write Maura as this really strong, independent woman, because I always have been. And you know, I think there's a little bit of me in all my female characters, you know. I can be quite ruthless. Oh, I read everyone and anyone. Last summer, I read over 200 books over about 5 months. And even now, I have to read the first page of a book to make sure that I haven't read it before. But I read everything from Game of Thrones. Obviously, I read Peter. He's absolutely fantastic. Peter, I love Linwood. God, Val's one of my favourite authors, Val McDermott. I adore Ian Rankin, Tesco. So I like everybody, really. I mean, I read an awful lot of crime. But I also read a lot of historical novels. I read a lot of true crime. And I also read a lot of autobiographies and things like that really interest me. I also read a lot of foreign authors as well. I do love to get, you know, I got Schilling's book years ago, you know, The Reader. And I made everybody read it, because it was so fantastic. I bought it in New York and I was like, oh my God, you, everybody's got to read this. If I like a book and I find a new author, I'll buy 10 copies and give them away. And I'll say, you must read this, you must read this. So I pretty much read everybody.